Almost all applications have at least a few use cases that require complex database operations. You can't define them using a few annotations in a Spring Data JPA repository. You need to create a composite repository. Whenever derived or custom queries are not powerful or flexible enough, you can add your own methods to your repository using a composite repository. It combines the ease of use of Spring Data's standard repositories with the flexibility of a custom implementation. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen. In this video, I will talk about composite repositories and how you can use them to extend your standard Spring Data JPA repositories. But before we begin, if you found this channel for the first time and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring, and all types of other Java persistence-related stuff, subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video to help me reach a broader audience. Composite repositories are easy to implement. You create an interface that defines your custom methods. This is called a fragment interface. You also need to create a custom implementation of that interface and integrate it with one of Spring Data JPA's standard repository interfaces. The definition of a composite repository looks very similar to a standard repository. You start by extending one of Spring Data's JPA repository interfaces, for example, the CRUD repository. In addition to that, you also extend your fragment interface. In this example, I called that interface Custom Author Repository. The fragment repository is a simple interface that defines the methods for which you want to provide your custom implementation. As you have seen in the previous code snippet, the author repository extends this and other repository interfaces, which provide the rest of the required functionality. In the example of this video, my fragment interface only defines the getAuthorsByFirstName method. In addition to the fragment interface, you need to provide an implementation of it. In this implementation, you can use Spring's dependency injection to get a reference to the entity manager and use it to provide the implementation of your repository methods. In this example, I use the criteria API to get all authors with a given first name as a list of author summary DTO objects. Since Spring 5, your repository can extend multiple fragment interfaces. That gives some extra flexibility for complex domain models and persistence layers. When you use multiple fragment interfaces to compose your repository, you get into the situation that two interfaces define a method with the same name. In the previous code snippet, the book repository extends the fragment repository's custom book repository and find all repository. The custom book repository defines the methods find books by author ID and find all. The find all repository only defines a find all method. As you can see, both fragments define a find all method. On an interface level, this is not a problem. As it's the case for all Java interfaces, the two methods get merged into one. But both fragment repositories can also provide their own independent implementations. In that case, the order in which you reference the fragment interfaces in your repository definition defines their priority. The implementation of the interface that gets referenced first gets used. Let's take another look at the definition of the book repository interface used in the previous section. As you can see, the custom book repository is listed before the find all repository. Because of that, the implementation of the custom book repository gets a higher priority. All calls on the find all method of the book repository will be forwarded to the implementation of the custom book repository fragment. Spring Data JPA repositories provide many standardized features that are easy to use and solve the most common use cases. Nonetheless, in some situations, you might need to provide your own implementation of a repository method. You can easily do that by using a composite repository. A composite repository extends a standard Spring Data JPA repository interface and one or more fragment interfaces. These are custom interfaces that define the methods for which you want to provide a custom implementation. In addition to the fragment interface, you also need to provide a class that implements that interface. Within that class, you can use Spring's dependency injection capabilities to get a reference to the entity manager and to implement the required logic. If multiple fragment interfaces define the same method and provide their own implementations, Spring uses the implementation of the Fragment interface that gets referenced first in the Composite Repository definition. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like cheat sheets and ebooks about JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!